inside the massive Impact Arena in Bangkok, Thailand. Muay Thai in four-ounce gloves. It doesn't get any better than this. Roundhouse kicks early from Superlek. He's going straight after Malchetra.
Start breaking down the body and go up top.
Now Chopra has reach in the arms. He's got to use it. He's got to keep Superlek at bay. Inside thigh kick there from the crook to my champion. Superlek goes downstairs. Controlling center in. Tracks away with the right leg again. That's under nicely done. Now Chopra applies a clean. Superlek gets a knee off to the ribs. And referee Onari breaks them. What a start here from the three-time world champion, Superlek. Outside of the kick again.
No.
Hands low, now lifts them. High on the balls of his feet. Cracks away with that roundhouse kick. Step through knee there from Superlek. He is pulling out all the weapons, all the eight weapons of Muay Thai here in the first round.
Go!
You can see Lao Tetra is having a hard time with the speed. I don't think he's used to starting this fast. Superlek is not following the Muay Thai rule set. He is going right after him in the first round, not giving him that warm-up round. You can see the speed difference.
Because Mitch, you can't here. This is one super series. It's only three rounds. You can't take a filling out process in the first and second. It's all about action. It's all about knockout. And that's what Superlek's looking for here in the opening stanza.
He is, and that's what, and you can see that Lao Tetra is having a hard time. He can't get into the clinch. He can't utilize those elbows. There it is. Now he's trying to fire the elbows.
A two-time Krung Khmer world champion in the white trunks. Finding the get-go very hard in the opening round here against a three-time world Muay Thai champion. Right hand down the tube there from Superlek, then goes to the bread basket. Planting right hand from Superlek. Now Chetra ties him up. Chunk for the knees, chunk for the elbow. Knee there from Lao Chetra. Downward elbow, hoping for the collarbone. Superlek just all over it. Planting up to his screen as the three-time world champion to see how much time's left in the round.
Interesting clinch game from Superlek. He's utilizing the outside over underhooks to get this because he's not trying to swim in and get inside control. He's very comfortable staying on the outside and using the defensive strategy so that he can create openings and throw elbows and knees of his own.
Go!
A tremendous start from Superlek Jitmuangnon. 2012 Sports Authority of Thailand, Muay Thai Fighter of the Year, three-time world champion.
Beautiful straight right hand from Superlek, right through the guard. Caught Lao Chetra, throws it as he just points the shot right at the tip of his forehead. Beautiful opening round for Superlek.
110 world champion martial artists here at home championship. You see one of them here, Superlek with a kicking arsenal. More kick than a porous line for Superlek here in the second round. And here come the hands.
Wow, it was like the first round. He actually was going kind of slow because that was 10 unanswered kicks from Lao Tetra by Superlek.
Make that 11. And there's 12, and there's 13. That right leg is devastating. Here comes the power from Superlek. Get Muga. Front kick to the midsection. Overhand elbow from Lao Chetra. Trying to get on the inside. And now Superlek ties him up against the ropes. A little slap and a tingle there from Atsushi Onari. And he breaks it. Look at the defense on the way in from Superlek. Wraps him over the forearms. That one goes down to the waist. That one goes down to the legs. It is all the right leg of Superlek here in the second round. Goes to the body, belly button through the back. Short elbow on the inside there from Lao Chetra.
Chetra needs more of that straight left hand or that right hand. He needs to put that jab out there. Every time Superlek throws a kick, he's got to answer it. He's got to come back.
High kicks again from Superlek, breaking down the forearms of Lao Chetra. Digs the toes into the midsection. Now needs to use that reach. High check there from the Cambodian. The three-time Muay Thai champion in the red and blue, Superlek Jitmuangnon, doing a number here in the second. Snakes the arms around the back of the neck, drills it into the midsection. Now no chance to get off the elbows. Referee, oh no, separates them. It is all out action in one super series. This is Muay Thai with four ounce gloves. This is the most electrifying martial arts stand-up in the world in 4 ounce gloves. And it's awesome to see, Mitch.
It is. And then what is awesome is that right kick from Superlek. He's thrown more right kicks than he has punches in this second round. Look at it, he just keeps hammering the body, the legs, the head of Lau Tetra.
That one to the humerus, but there was nothing funny about it. Like a pinch up in the corner. He got put on by Superlek. Tango against the ropes and referee. Oh, now he breaks them. Final seconds of what has been a cracking second stanza for the three-time Muay Thai world champion, Superlek. And again with the right. Body shot there. Behind the balls of his feet, Superlek. Dancing, grooving. Oozing confidence from every pore. And there's going to be a lot of work for now, chapter to two in the final round.
Let's count how many kicks he threw in that opening stanza of the second round. He just goes off and repeatedly, like machine gun fire, starts unloading these kicks. He goes to the arms, he goes to the body, he goes to the head, just over and over. We saw this guy hitting pads this week, and he hits pads like he's hitting the body. Look at him just going over and over to the legs, to the arms, to the body, just punishing Lau Tetra from all angles.
Third and final round. It's been one-way traffic, and all the traffic has come via that right leg, the right shin of Superlek Jitmuangnon.
Shade than the right side of his body.
It looks like it's been sunburned. It's reddened the entire carcass and the legs of Lau Tetra. And Superlek sets the right leg again, boom, to the midsection. Lau Tetra backs him up, tries for a flying knee to no avail. Chucks the elbows off the right here. And referee, oh, now he breaks it.
We're seeing incredible offensive strategy from Superlek, but we're seeing defense as well. We're seeing a very pinpoint, accurate defensive strategy from Superlek. And that's what's made Lau Tetra so frustrated with. He's not able to do anything. We just saw it as he was trying to jump in for that knee. Just a little subtle adjustment from Superlek, and he was able to stop the jump. It's very impressive.
You are seeing the skill. The poise, the speed, and the scintillating power that has made Superlek Jitmuangnon a three-time world Muay Thai champion. Racks away again with the right roundhouse kick. That shin has done incredible damage. Knee guard put on here by Superlek. And referee Onari separates both these warriors. Two tremendous athletes, two world champions. Southpaw stance on the Cambodian. His inside leg is a shade of purple, a kaleidoscope for colors. The crowd are counting the kicks from Superlek. And they spill to the canvas. Nice dump there from Superlek Jitmuangnon. Slow to pick himself up. Here's Lau Tetra. 1:05 remaining. Three judges ringside scoring on a 10-point must system. And you figure they must have given the first round 10-9, the second round 10-9 to Superlek, the three-time world Muay Thai champion. Superlek winds up the roundhouse kick again, gets out of the way of the elbow. A nice low check there from Superlek. Winds up the right again, here it comes, there it goes to the body, doubles up on it. Overhand elbow from Lau Tetra, downward elbow! Looking to press the collarbone of Jitmuangnon.
That's what Lau Tetra said he wanted to do. He wanted to close that distance and start dropping those elbows. He's able to do it last 30 seconds of the match.
There's a very special lady, we're going to show you her in a moment, who is screaming amongst our super fans here ringside. I'll tell you who she is in a few seconds' time, but she is going bananas for someone in the ring right now. Jumping knee from Lau
Panpayak Jitmuangnon.
Big start from Superlek, and the crowd are loving it. He has to be very careful, just effortlessly just moved out of range, and at the end again, really great economy of effort from Adillo. And he comes in range with a left and a right, short punches. We'll have a blow there from Superlek. What a nice start, Mitch.
Superlek is coming with a lot more heat than we've seen in strike matches in the past.
Instantly. Three knockdowns in one round equals a technical knockout, so watch for that with 2:13 left in this opener.
See, Superlek starting to bring the heat.
Patel, this is what Patel's got to do. He's got to make it dirty. He can't stand at range, especially kicking range.
Referee Olivier Cost just making sure that clinch doesn't go on for too long. It's all action here. Right hand from Patel was a nice one. As Superlek was coming in. Flying knee! Huge noise from the crowd behind me here in Bangkok. Just grabbed that foot, hit from a colossal right hand. Botello ducked underneath it.
See how well Superlek is using the fence. He's able to back Botello up because Botello's not circling out. He can't let Superlek to come in like this.
Botello holding all he can there. Superlek unleashing a great effort and straight back into it as Olivier Cost supports him and brings them together. Right hand, nice short punch from Superlek.
And he's parrying down the lead hand. Botello with his lead hand, he's swapping down the hand. That's what's going to circle around and land that big right hand.
This is so intense from Superlek. You get the feeling that Botello is just being a little bit reactionary, just looking at what's going to happen and see if he can counter. It's certainly Superlek that is leading the action. Just has a little brush of his right eye there to see if he's been marked.
Nice right hand landed by Botello. That's what he needs more of. He needs to close that distance and throw those hands.
Superlek comes back with a right of his own. These two are just not holding back. 35 seconds left in this opening round. It's been wonderful action. Looking for the spinning back elbow there, Botello. Charging in with the kick to the head. Back in the center of the circle now. 24 seconds left. The right hand from Superlek comes back. But his leg is held. And they go down to the mat. And Superlek landed quite heavily. Botello landed on top of him. So a little bit of a warning there from Olivier Cost. 10 seconds left in this opening round. It's been all action. Super stuff.
Good job by Botello to get that leg up and check that right kick. That's what he needs more of. Then he's letting those right hands land. Look at that beautiful push kick landed by Superlek. Then he fakes it. He lands the push kick, lifts up the knee, fakes the push kick, and then comes over the top. And that was an elbow that landed. Look at that. Beautiful. Done. Look at that. Oh, wow. Just superb. Now they have to adjust their style of defense to complement the little gloves.
Pushing Botello back. Right hand as well, followed up with a foot. Every strike he throws is being cheered by the home fans here. Botello battling not only his opponent, but the entire Impact Arena, seemingly. Botello just looking over his shoulder, trying to take a little bit of advice from his corner man. Yes, they know everything about this sport. Fans here at the Impact Arena. Muay Thai is their bread and butter, and they are really enjoying this. Hope you can hear their cheers at home every time something is thrown. And it's good work from Superlek, isn't it? Knees to the side of the body, answered by Botello.
Botello's showing some good eyes. He's been able to evade a lot of the big kicks thrown by Superlek, and then Superlek actually starts kicking at the hip. So instead of Botello moving out of the way, those hips don't move, and he starts attacking.
Now, as Botello's leg was caught and he went down. Superlek looked for a kick as it was falling. And Olivier Coste just giving him a little warning there that that's not quite the done thing.
Botello's tough. It's that body kick. There's a big right hook.
Olivier Coste is working almost as hard as these two athletes. 121 left of the second round.1 minute left of the second round. The action continues to be relentless. Left, right from Botello. Not cleanly landed though. Superlek ushers him in. Says, come on, let's have a battle here in the center of the circle.
Botello can't get sucked into that game. He's got to keep moving.
Botello gets pushed back to the circle wall there with a super kick to the center of the body.
Superlek's trying to egg him on, and Botello's answering, but he's got to move. He cannot just play this game with Superlek.
30 seconds left. Everything into that kick, but it was parried by Botello. He's enjoying this, isn't he? The tie. Big right hand just crushes the jaw. Just gets a little bit untidy. Dying moments of this second round. A Muay Thai contest for us all to enjoy here. Bangkok, Thailand. The fans enjoying the final moments as Superlek goes to war again with that right leg. Ragdolls his man to the ground. There's a little bit of tension between these two. His opponent, Superlek in the right, and again he goes up high with the leg and then comes downstairs to the ribcage. And again he's beckoning. Botello in, just teasing him, annoying him. Oh, what a wonderful kick that was to the jaw, follows it up with another one, and Botello might be in a bit of trouble here. The elbow to the head as well. Superlek's leg gets held. The action in the first 30 seconds of this round has been intense. Kick to the waist there from Superlek. Damaging sort of teep kick above the knee that can hyperextend it. Also clearly in his arsenal. Has a little shake of the head there, Superlek. Not quite going the way he wants it to. He's got just over 2 minutes to give this crowd a spectacular finish.
Good balance by Superlek. As Botello had his leg elevated, tried to sweep out, but he was the one that ended up down. Superb balance shown by Superlek.
Good work to the body from the Portuguese, couple of left hands. Nice and low to the ribcage. Earning the respect of Superlek, who's teased him at times. Power of that kick, and now Botello. Now Botello gives him a little smile and a nod and extends the hand of friendship, the sportsmanship that we see so often in the World Championship Circle. Good right hand from Superlek, landed flush on the jaw. 120 left of this third and final round.
So those kicks are landing to the hip of Botello because he's got good eyes. He's moving out of the way of the head kick. So Superlek's attacking that right left side of the body and the hip of Botello.
And Botello comes in with these punches. And if he misses, which he occasionally does, he is very vulnerable to a sharp counter from the top. Olivier Coste really has had a workout in this one. Once again, sportsmanship on show, 45 seconds left. Elbow coming in from Superlek, and it landed. A bit of a clinch there. The circle wall.
The way Superlek comes in, gains those distance with those elbows, and they come from a lot of different angles, Steve.
Just wanted to remark upon the sportsmanship again there, Mitch. It's been fiercely contested, this one, but in the spirit that we so commonly see in one championship. And once again, Superlek just has a little paw at that eye to see if there's been any damage done. It's clearly bothering him a little bit. So Botello knows he's done some damage. Is it enough, though, when the judges...
My unanimous decision. decision from the red corner, Superlek.
Fahdi Khaled and Huang Ding, Tunisia versus China. Fahdi brings in the experience and opens up the leg kick early. Front kick from Fahdi Khaled. We expect Fahdi to use the legs. Huang Ding goes heavy on the hands. Cannot afford to take his time to warm up here though. Huang Ding needs to get stuck straight into the action. Fahdi Khaled trying to control centering. Keep Huang Ding on the outside. Fires out the front kick. Huang Ding edges forward. Doesn't throw the right hand though. Good use of the push, kicks off the lead leg from Fahdi Khaled. Throws a round kick off the right, drifts off counterclockwise. Both men clash shins. Tight guard here on Fahdi Khaled is high. Does up for a target though on the rib cage of Khaled, should Huang Ding go after with his roundhouse kicks. You have got to wonder though how the big occasion will affect Huang Ding tonight. On the biggest stage of all here at ONE Championship. Again, using those front kicks and push kicks. Thought about a jumping knee and a high left round. Another front kick there from Fahdi Khaled. Doing a good job here, Khaled. Goes the inside thigh. May have just clipped the groin cup there of Huang Ding. Khaled brings in a record of 39 and 8. Huang Ding not far off, 30 and 7. They call Khaled the gladiator. And the gladiator continues to come forward on the red trunks of Huang Ding. Huang Ding out of Hewan, China. Only 22 years old. So many great Chinese athletes in ONE Super Series. They really have come on strongly over the last 18 months here. And we are seeing a new breed in Huang Ding. Nice high kick there from Fahdi Khaled. Tries to get airborne. Does the Tunisian sticks out that left leg. Low check. Huang Ding has not used the legs nearly enough here. Fahdi Khaled has been on the attack constantly since the opening bell. It's been an impressive round. We do have three judges ringside scoring on a 10-point must system, which means give the winner of the round 10 points. The less dominant athletes gets 9. A flurry there from Fahdi Khaled. They lock up. Chance for the knees, chance for the elbows. Allowed under these Muay Thai rules. Muay Thai known as the art of 8 weapons. The hands, the elbows, the knees, and of course, the kicks. Oh, downward elbow from Fahdi Khaled. How do you do? Trying to crack the clavicle of Huang Ding. Beautiful work from Fahdi Khaled. Didn't take him long to open up the elbow artillery, Fahdi Khaled. Now goes down to the sternum. Good jab too there from the Tunisian. And Huang Ding returns the favour. But this is all one-way traffic so far. Another chopping strike there from Fahdi Khaled. He has turned on the fireworks in the opening round, Dragon.
Yeah, that first round was all Fahdi Khaled. You kind of see as the round progressed, Huang Ding kind of got a little bit gun-shy and was afraid to truly commit.
As we open up round 2 of 3, let's see if Huang Ding can maintain centering here. Fahdi turns around easily, presses him against the ropes, a couple of knees in the clinch, and already a good start from Fahdi Khaled. Dukes it out with the hands, does Fahdi. Downward elbow again from the Tunisian. We are seeing the full employ of all 8 weapons early on here from Fahdi Khaled as he dumps Huang Ding to the canvas. Beautifully executed from Fahdi Khaled. Jumping front kick. The front kicks off the lead leg of Khaled have been superb. Cracks down to the lead thigh. Nice turning left. And oh, how taste my feet, says Fahdi Khaled. Beautifully done from the Tunisian Dragon.
You can start to see Huang Ding starting to push forward. He's trying to get aggressive. But Fahdi Khaled just keeps throwing. He does not stop. And this is what we saw a lot from him in his match against Ruantang. But Ruantang just ultimately outworked him. But you can see, oh, he got caught there. It was a stumble.
Can Huang Ding power back, staring down the barrel of a 10-9 loss in the first round. And again, the step-up elbows here from Fahdi Khaled. The front kick from the Tunisian goes downstairs looking for that quadricep area. Cracks away to the upper right rib cage. Step-through elbow there from Huang Ding, crossing elbow from the Chinese athlete. just couldn't connect though. Those elbows are going to slice and dice and fillet the face server. Fahdi Khaled to no avail though. Fahdi's experience at the highest stage coming through so far tonight. The volume, the aggression, and as I said earlier, the use of all eight weapons of Muay Thai will certainly be looking good to the judges here in Thailand. Step across, outside leg kick there from Huang Ding. High kick from Fahdi Khaled. Launches that one, just looking to crack away to the forearms of Huang Ding. A lot of the Muay Thai kicks will be aimed at the arms deliberately to break the arms down, cause the opponent to drop their arms, expose the head, expose the neck, and they can come over the top of the kicks for a knockout. That's what Fahdi Khaled's been trying to do, break down the forearm. There's another couple of knees in the midsection. Tries to fold Huang Ding in half like origami. Back against the ropes now in the clinch. A chance for the elbows and the knees. Good knee to the midsection there from Khaled. Crossing elbow from Huang Ding and they break off. Moving to the final stages of the second round. It's been a corker of a contest. Khaled goes to the lead thigh, liver, thigh again. Good combination work. This has been a treat to watch from Fahdi Khaled. The Tunisian all over, 22-year-old Huang Ding. Fahdi Khaled looking for career victory number 40. 4 centimeter height advantage for Huang Ding really hasn't come into play. And Mitch, I've got to say, another very impressive round for the volume, the aggression, and the array of weapons of Fahdi Khaled. I feel here that's going to be a strength for Huang Ding. He needs to get aggressive and maybe a little reckless. He's going to start throwing at angles that Fahdi Khaled can't predict here. It's time to pull out all the stops for Huang Ding because he is losing 2 rounds to Nil Dragon.
Yeah, he might have been pacing himself. He might have been kind of saving things up until this final round, but that was a beautiful front kick to the face that Khaled landed. But he keeps coming forward. He keeps trying, but he's not firing anything. He's just standing there. Now he's starting to go. But see that beautiful little sidestep from Khaled? He just knows what's coming at him.
Some better signs here for Huang Ding. Looping shot to the body. Fahdi Khaled saw that one coming. Khaled goes inside lead thigh to that femoral profunda. Jabs here from Huang Ding, no right hand for company. Oh, stinging punch to the jaw there from Fahdi Khaled, and again loads up that right hand. There is no margin for error in these 4 ounce gloves. They are unforgiving, and Fahdi Khaled is using them a treat here in the third and final round. The Tunisian, a house on fire. Ties up Huang Ding now. They tango back against the ropes. A chance for the knees. But referee Kaplun breaks them. Huang Ding comes forward. Oh, in the corner there. Fahdi Khaled. Just a slip. Huang Ding needs to up the aggressor meter. Time is against the young man from China. Beautiful step across leg kick. Jumping knee from Fahdi Khaled. Pulling out all the stops is Fahdi Khaled. Is Huang Ding a little overawed by being on the biggest martial arts stage on the planet? Long reach on the right hand there from Fahdi Khaled. Rocks the head back. And Huang Ding does a quick count of his teeth. Looks for the uppercut. But not committing here, Huang Ding. Khaled sets himself. The way that he tucks the chin, looks through the brow. It's just excellence in execution all round, offensively and defensively for Fahdi Khaled. Final stages of this bout. It'll take a minor miracle now for Huang Ding to try and peg it back. The front kicks have been superb. So too the outside leg kicks from Fahdi Khaled. He's been working combinations. Packed with power all night, Fahdi Khaled. And he may be seconds away from claiming victory number 40 in his career. The WMC Intercontinental Champion against the top prospect from the One Hero Series. But it's been a dominating performance from Fahdi Khaled. He gave up weight. He gave up height. He had experience, and that has shot through tonight. Fahdi Khaled will take this one on the judges' scorecards. Mitch, he was all over Huang Ding.
Yeah, Fahdi Khaled just put on a masterclass. He was extremely aggressive, but he was also very accurate. Huang Ding did have his moments, but just instances like that where Huang Ding goes to the body, his hands are down, so Khaled goes beautifully up top with the elbow.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner from the blue corner, Fahdi Khaled.
Panpayak has beaten Superlek four times, lost once and drew once. Panpayak, 8-2 in his last 10, including wins over Rui Botello, over Superlek Ketmulgao and Davison Bashao. Good outside leg kick there from Superlek Ketmulgao. Panpayak in southpaw stance, Superlek in orthodox stance. Superlek known as the kicking machine. Lumpini Stadium champion in two weight divisions, Superlek, 118 and 114 pounds. WBC world champion at super featherweight, Superlek Ketmulgao. Both men just seeing what each other has to offer in the opening round. Panpayak Jitmuangnon in the black trunks. A Muay Thamur stylist, meaning he's a technical athlete who uses his range exceptionally well. The equivalent in boxing would be a Floyd Mayweather. In fact, Mayweather was an inspiration for Panpayak when he was younger. Solid start here from Superlek Ketmulgao. Jab outside leg kick from Superlek. Comes over with the hands now. Roundhouse kick, then body shot from Superlek. Panpayak ties him up in the corner. Superlek scores with a knee off to the left. Online voting polls on the One Championship Twitter feed have 30% of fans saying Superlek will win tonight. 46% are sitting on the fence undecided. Panpayak does have the upper hand. As I said, he's beaten Superlek four times, lost once, drawn once. Good roundhouse kick to the ribs there from Panpayak. Superlek trying to press him against the ropes here. Controlling center in, hooked to a round kick there from Superlek Ketmulgao. 45 seconds remains in what's been a gripping first round so far, Dragon.
Yeah, these guys know each other so well, they can almost calculate exactly what's gonna happen in this match. Panpayak's trying to use the kicks to keep Superlek away while Superlek is trying to close that distance and let those hands go.
25 seconds on the clock now. Superlek, who has gone 7-3-1 in his last 10, including 2-0 in one Super Series, has beaten some great names. Sung Mani, Jonathan Hagerty, Christopher Shaw, Wong Tai, Saksan Okwon Wong. The list goes on for the great Superlek Ketmulgao. Nice step through knee off the right leg there. Let us know, folks around the world, how you scored the first round in this seventh match. Good outside leg kick to open up there from Superlek. Throws the hands, goes high off the right leg, Superlek. Inside leg kick, Superlek, hunting that femoral artery. Tip kick to the lead leg there from Panpayak Jitmuangnon. Left hook, round kick combination there from Superlek. 121 wins in 151 outings for a huge 80% finishing rate for Superlek Ketmulgao. Very technical style, as you're seeing. Powerful knees for Superlek. Big soccer fan, football fan in his spare time. Supports Buriram United FC locally and Chelsea in the English Premier League. Long reach on the left hand there from Panpayak, and a gut-munching knee clinched up in the corner. And referee Klaukan breaks them. We said the peak winning rate of Superlek at 80%. Well, Panpayak has that beaten. An enormous 84% winning rate. Extraordinary high winning rate in the sport of Muay Thai for Panpayak Jitmuangnon, the 24-year-old. 230 wins, 34 knockouts. Panpayak, originally from Samut Prakam, about 30 kilometers outside of Bangkok, takes the round kick and gives one back off his left leg, being the rear leg in southpaw stance. They clinch, center of the ring, jockeying for arm positioning. Referee Cloud Clown allows them to grapple for a moment. Decided there wasn't enough action and breaks them. 1:05 remaining, second round of three dragon.
Lots of forward pressure coming off from Superlek. You can see him trying to land those kicks, trying to open up that left side of the body of Panpayak. Maybe get him to start covering up with the elbows to that body shot so he can start letting go of the hands up top of the head. But so far, very close matchup. These guys have so much history and they know each other so well. It's just these minor little details who can really get things going in these three round super series matchups.
Nice little knee on the inside there from Superlek Mukau. Half a minute remaining, second of three. Very close contest here. Round kicks off the right leg from Superlek, off the left leg from Panpayak. Two-time Lumpini Stadium champion at 118 and 126 pounds, Panpayak. Two-time Rajdamern champion at 108 and 105 pounds. Beat the great Sam A. Gangadao for the Lumpini featherweight title, I remember, back in 2015. In the same year, he knocked out Sam A with a high left kick in just 80 seconds at Rajdamern Stadium. As we go to the towers at the end of Two Dragon. There's a hit kick early from Superlek to open the third and final. Lines it up again off the right leg. Lowers the boom a little on that occasion. Thought about the jab in Panpayak and again Superlek. That's why they call him the kicking machine. If he starts to set the metronome with that right leg, he will be hard to stop, Superlek. Panpayak goes downstairs. A little higher there. Nice wall built by Superlek on the defense. Comes forward, gets into the clinch, backs up Panpayak now. Chance for the knees, knee bar put on by Superlek and referee Cloud Clan. That breaks them. Round kick from Panpayak, the 24-year-old. Three-time Sports Writers of Thailand Athlete of the Year, 2013, 2014, 2015 for Panpayak. That's like winning the MVP in the NBA or winning the Ballon d'Or in soccer. He won it three times in a row, Panpayak Jitmuangnon. Nice defense against the round kick there. 1:40 remaining. Is it still anyone's for the taking here, Dragon? How do you see it as we're into the final 90 seconds?
Man, this is pretty close. You can just see how well these guys kind of nullify each other's games. This is like their 38th round that they've competed against each other. I haven't had like sparring partners that I've had that much time against. They know each other so well. And you can see that from these shots. Every time they throw, they're deflecting it. They're just these little tiny scores that might happen. And it might be happening inside the clinch, because that's what we've seen a lot in their past matchups, is we've seen Panpayak score successfully inside that clinch because he's got that length on Superlek.
You know what's really scary, Mitch, is that inside this audience-free arena where you can hear a pin drop, we are hearing the mighty thumping power of these Muay Thai techniques from two of the finest to ever do it, Panpayak and Superlek. The careening of the round kicks into the legs, into the body. I mean, it sends a shiver down your spine. Can you imagine the sounds we'll be hearing, folks, later on in the night when Jodson Klai starts to wind up his round kicks, when Rod Tung starts to attack the body in 4 ounce gloves. Frightening sounds from an amazing sport brought to you by One Super Series. 15 seconds on the clock here. looking for a combination as Superlek went high with the kick. We are going to go down to the judges yet again in this heated rivalry that's been going on for so long. Match number 7. Some great action, Mitch, in the clinch.
Yeah, that's where, I mean, in the first round, we start to see these guys kind of in that kicking and punching range. But as the match wore on, they both kind of fell into that kick, that clinch, where they just got nice and tight. Beautifully, you can see a little bit of a stumble there from Panpayak. Didn't really score, but just constant back and forth action. Ever so close. I think it's going to, you know, come down to that third and final round exactly who did more work inside that clinch and was just more active.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner from the blue corner, Superlek Jitmuangnon.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.